Okay, let me go to another subject, because perhaps the most controversial reform that the president announced Friday is to extend privacy rights to foreigners. Here's what the president had to say about that.
People around the world, regardless of their nationality, should know that the United States is not spying on ordinary people who don't threaten our national security. And that we take their privacy concerns into account in our policies and procedures.
Senator Leahy, I can understand because of the diplomatic uproar with Angela Merkel, the idea that we're not going to wiretap or eavesdrop on our allies, someone like a foreign leader. Why on earth would we extend our constitutional protections to foreigners, particularly when we know those countries are spying on us?
I don't think that's what the president said. Now, as General Hayden and I both know, without going into classified material, we have, as people know, we have relationships with all the intelligence services among our allies. We share a great deal of information from them in both directions. I think a lot of these countries were getting such feedback against the United States, saying, why are they spying on us too? I think the president had to say something like this to know we're being protected. There was a growing, and I think erroneous, feeling in other countries that somehow the United States was in tapping all of them. And I think this was probably a way of helping some of our allies say it's okay for us to cooperate with the United States.
Well, let me ask you, General Hayden, is that what this is? Is this a PR move? The president said that we will continue to survey foreigners when it comes to...
PR is your word, not mine.
I understand that. Counterintelligence or cybersecurity, right. Is that what this is, basically, that he's saying we're not going to do things that we weren't doing already?
Look, if your definition of a PR move is to restore trust and confidence domestically and abroad, that's exactly what the president's doing. And what he's done here, it's very interesting, Chris, and the president's language was very precise. He did not commit to pulling back on collection against foreign targets other than heads of state and heads of government. What he's talking about is the retention of that data and then how it's disseminated. And that part he does say, we'll use the same standards we use for American persons. Frankly, that's practice now. But this is one of the things that concerned me. Remember I mentioned administrative burden before. We do that with great oversight for Americans. And it is administratively burdensome. This is probably a tenfold increase in the paperwork requirement. We'll see how much the system can stand that.
I want to make it clear, though, as we wrap this up, I want to move to one other subject, that basically there's a lot less that the president changes than what he does change, and I want to talk about that. The government will still be able to issue national security letters, a broad subpoena power. They will still be able to build back doors into software and hardware of private companies to collect information. Let me get you both briefly to answer this, because the impression I get, and maybe I'm wrong, General, isn't the basic surveillance structure that George W. Bush started after 9/11, isn't that still intact?
Absolutely. And I'd add one more item to your list about going after encryption. His commission said we should pull back on that. He never mentioned encryption once in his talk.
So in terms of the basic surveillance structure of George W. Bush?
Exactly. Of course. No, that's exactly what the president has embraced it. He has got a political problem, and I don't mean to trivialize it, because in a democracy, political problems are very serious. He needs consent of the governed. He's willing to shave points off of flexibility, add administrative burdens, add oversight. But the objective, Chris, is to keep on doing what he's doing.
Briefly, Senator Leahy, you agree?
I think that we are going to maintain our ability to protect the United States. That's extremely important. Talk about encryption. We know that there's attacks on the United States all the time from foreign governments,
right,
as well as others. We saw this attack on Target, which is an enormous problem for this country. So we will protect against that. The concern everybody has is allowing our government to have such a reach into your private life, my private life, and everybody else's, that we have the government controlling us instead of us controlling the government. And that's what both Republicans and Democrats are joined together on the Hill to try to change.
All right.